teacher Vanessa.
I'm teacher Peter.
And we are so excited today to be worshiping with you. So why don't we all stand up, get ready, stand up, and move around, wiggle a bit.
Stand up.
Stretch.
Get up.
And we'll start worship. Yay! Boys and girls, this is teacher Vanessa, and I'll be reading Psalms 107, verses 8 to 9. Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wondrous works to the children of man. For he satisfies the longing soul, and the hungry soul he fills with good things.
Your praise. We could see how much
Hey kids, it's teacher Peter, and I'm going to be reading from Psalms chapter 24, verses 1 to 6. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? And who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to what is false, and does not swear deceitfully. He will receive blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob.
Tap Kids, this is Teacher Shireen, and I'm excited to study the Word of God with you this morning. So before we start, let's go ahead and pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you so much, God, for your Word. We thank you, God, that your Word is life, your Word is power, your Word is truth. Jesus, I pray that you would soften our hearts, that you would sharpen our mind, and that you would help us to hear about you and be changed by you this morning. Amen. So if you have your Bibles, I want you to turn with me to James chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. Okay, one more time. James chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. Says, come now, you who are rich, for terrible things are coming your way. All your riches have no value. You have invested in evil. You have abused your power over the laborers who worked under you. The cries of the laborers have reached the ears of God. This is the word of the Lord. So boys and girls, so James, our friend from the Bible, he tells us of some friends that he knew. Some of them were rich. They had a lot of money and power. The Bible tells us that they also had a lot of fields. And there were laborers who were probably poor. They worked
in these fields. James tells us that our rich friends who had a lot of money and had a lot of power, they used their money and power to treat the laborers in the fields unfairly. They didn't pay the laborers well. They probably used their power to make the laborers work hard. And so the Bible tells us that these laborers, they cried out to Jesus. They asked for help. The Bible also tells us that Jesus, he heard their cries, and he was not happy with the rich friends. And so James tells us that Jesus was unhappy, and he reminds his rich friends that what they have done is not right. The Bible uses the word evil, that what they did was abuse over these poor laborers. And so that's our story. And so today, James reminds us something really, really important. God calls us, boys and girls, to be good stewards of what God has given us. Now, stewards, that's a big word, right? Before we understand what that means, I'm going to teach you our first lesson point for today. And that is that God owns all things, okay? That everything that we have belongs to Jesus. Now let's see, I have crayons here. I love colors, so these crayons. I have some cards here. Even these things belong to God. My house, you see in the background, everything in my house belongs to God. My clothes, the food that I eat, the bed that I sleep on, my mommy and daddy, my friends, everything, boys and girls, belongs to God. So the first lesson we learned today is that everything belongs to God. And the second lesson that we learned today is that God calls us to be good stewards of the gifts that he has given us. And so what that means is to use whatever resources that God has given us, our toys, our clothes, our food, our friends, our money, everything God has given us for his glory, in a manner that we love God and love the people around us. First Peter, if you turn back into your Bible, chapter 4, verses 10, it says, as each of you has received a gift, use it to serve one another as stewards of God's grace. 1 Corinthians 4, 2, it says, stewards are called to be trustworthy. And so what this really means is that God, when he gives us these things, our toys, our food, all our clothes, everything that we have, our books, our friends, when God gives us these perfect things that belongs already to God, he is also calling us to be good stewards of all the things that God has given us. And God entrusts these things to us. So when God has given me these cards, right, these all my toys, God is trusting me to use it in a manner to love God and to love the people around me. And so today, we're going to go through three things that we can do practically to be good stewards of all that God has given us. So the first thing is, I want you, maybe if you're in upper elementary or low elementary, I want you to get your notepads real quick, run real quick, and get a pencil and write these down. If you're super smart, you're like, I can remember it with my smart brain. I want you to take a note of what I'm gonna go through. Okay, so the first thing is God calls us to give thanks. So every morning, as soon as you wake up, maybe right after you brush your teeth, take a minute and say, thank you, God, for the things that you have given me. Or before you go to bed, right after you brush your teeth, and maybe it's like time to just, you know, fall asleep right before that, take some time to say, God, thank you for all that you have given me today. The second thing is to make a plan. Sometimes we forget, right, that God has given us all these things. And so a great way to remember and to use the things that God has given us for his glory is to make a plan. So for example, I am going to say, I have all these crayons. I'm going to use it to do kind things. So I will draw a card for my siblings. I would maybe use it to do finish my coloring page from a book that I got from Sunday school, I would use it to do kind things. And so the second thing that we learn is to make a plan. So the first thing, give thanks, and then make a plan. And thirdly is to give generously. Sometimes, you know, we forget that God has given us these things. And so we hoard them, right? We say, no, they're mine. These crayons are mine. These toys are mine, not yours. And then when our siblings want to share with us, we say, no, no, no. The Bible tells us that God calls us to give generously. And so when we give, the Bible tells us that that reminds us that everything that we have belongs to God. So for example, my grandma, last Christmas, she gave me $20. Whoa, that's a lot of money, right? So here's my plan. I want to make sure that I give to God, that I give to my friends, maybe even collect, maybe save some money so that I can give it to something important. And maybe I'm going to do something fun for myself. So here's how I am going to spend these $20. Ready? So $20. So I'm going to give $5 for offering. Ooh, I wanted this new pack of crayons. I mean, I like this. It's really nice, but I wanted this new pack. And my mommy told me that it was $10. So I'm going to spend $10 to buy a new pack of crayons. So I had $20, $5 for offering, $10 to buy a new pack of crayons. Oh, $5 more. I'm going to use the last $5 to put in my saving bank. Teacher Alejandro is actually going to teach us later today how to have our own saving bank and how we can save up enough so that we can give generously. So that's all I have for you, boys and girls. But before we close our time here, let's go ahead and pray. So today we learned that all things belongs to God. God calls us to be good stewards of all the resources that He has given us. So on that note, let's go ahead and pray. Jesus, we thank you for reminding us, God, that everything that we have belongs to you. Help us when we forget to stop, to say that we're sorry, and to turn to you, God. Help us not to be like the rich friends that James talked about, but help us to be people who give generously, God. So Jesus, this week, help us to make our saving bank, to save as much as we can so that we can give as much as we can. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you've given us. Everyone say amen. Thank you, boys and girls. See you next week. Hey there, Tap Kids! It is summertime! You guys are probably wondering, what in the world are we going to do this summer? Well, today we have good news for you. Coach Jimmy, all the way from
Philadelphia,
is going to teach us a tennis 101. Get ready, boys and girls.
Woo! Thank you, Shireen. Hey, kids. So, tennis is one of my favorite sports, and I'm going to show you two things today. Basically a tennis form, it's called a forehand, and an exercise you can do to kind of help you improve your eye-hand coordination. So what a forehand is it's really about the proper swing. So there's a starting stance and then the swing part. So I'm going to show you kind of what that looks like. So the starting stance should be what I call 2 o'clock looking through the window. What I mean by that is if this is 12 o'clock, this is 6 o'clock, this is 1 o'clock, then this is 2 o'clock. You're looking through your racket kind of like you're looking through the window. This is your starting stance in tennis. So you start like this. When the ball comes, step one, you loop around, you swing through the ball above your shoulder, and you catch with your left hand. So let me show you what that looks like. So again, one more time, just to kind of go over the basics, is you always want to start 2 o'clock you're looking through the window, kind of like your racket string is the window. You loop around, swing above your shoulders, and catch with your left hand. So that is the most basic form of a forehand. It's for whether you're a beginner, you've been playing tennis, it's a great practice, and it's one of the most important shots of the game. The second thing I want to show you guys is, it's called dribbling the ball on your racket. So let me show you what this looks like. See how the ball stays right in front of me? And it's kind of very steady. What you don't want it to happen is the ball go like this, right? But you want to keep it in front of you. What this does is it allows you to learn control, but more importantly, it allows you to work on what we call eye-hand coordination. So my challenge to you is, I want you guys to get your parents, put you on Instagram, and I want everybody to be able to do 20 of these without dropping the ball. So ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So that was it for Tennis 101. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you again soon. Bye.
Happy Sunday, Tap Kids. Happy to be here with you guys one more time. My name is Teacher Alejandro, and today we are going to be making something fun. Teacher Shireen, she talked about giving and how we're supposed to give generously because God has given us so much, and everything that we have is because of God, right? And sometimes it's really hard, although we know that we're supposed to give, it's really hard to remember, right? John Wesley said, earn as much as you can, save as much as you can, and give as much as you can. But like I said, sometimes we forget that we have to give because we like, you know, we like buying stuff for ourselves, right? Giving sometimes doesn't feel that good, but it's great once you do it, right? And you must be wondering, right? Where do I save the money that I get from my parents, from my allowance? Where can I put it? And that's why today we are going to be making a giving bank, right? So you're going to make it essentially a piggy bank, right? All right, so let's get started on making our giving bank. What are we going to need? We are going to need a box, preferably a box. That way, you know, you can just wrap it easier. But if you can do it with a tube if you want, like a big jar, that's fine. So I need some construction paper. I got some blue, some yellow, some red, some of my favorite colors. We are gonna need markers, you know, because we're gonna decorate it the way we like it. And we are gonna need some stickers. I have some hearts here, some balls, a lot of things. We are gonna need scissors, so please be careful when using the scissors. I don't want any of you guys to get injured or hurt. So make sure your parents are watching you, okay? And tape. So now, let's get started, yeah? All right. So, first things first. Grab the paper and start wrapping it. You know, wrap it, there you go. We got some tape. You know, there you go. Voila. See? Grab another piece of tape. And there you go. We'll tape it together. Right? And then go ahead and just cover the edges. Cover the edges. You know. Cover the edges and then tape it once it's all covered up. You know, you can actually put tapes on the table. That way it's easier for you, right? So when you need the tape again, just look at the table and you'll have some, right? It'll save you some time. So, there you go. You know, and this is just a trial because I actually already made one, which I'll show you guys after this, right? But, you know, but I wanted to just teach you guys step by step. So once you guys already covered it all, you guys have an idea, right? Let's see. You see? Now it's already covered up. So what we're gonna do next, we are gonna go ahead and start decorating. Decorate it the way you want to. Well, you know, we can go ahead and put some stickers. Bam. How many of you guys like volleyball? If you can't see it, it's a volleyball sticker. I know some of you guys love playing volleyball. Let's see, go ahead and stick it right here. And then, football. Who remembers the Super Bowl? I know I do. So much fun. Go ahead and just put this one right here. Yeah. All right. There you go. What else? Oh, basketball. You can never go wrong with basketball. For my basketball lovers. Right here. Put the sticker here. Voila. You know. And let's see, what else do we have? Oh, let's not forget heart, right? Let's not forget the love. And it's just a reminder, let's put some love in this giving back. Because when we give, you know, we're loving on someone else. And that's what God calls us to do, to love on our neighbors, right? There you go. So then, you know, we're going to go ahead and write on it. I'm going to get a red marker because red's one of my favorite colors. And I'm gonna name it Alex's Bank. Alex. Bank. You see? Voila. You know, and I just named it Alex's Bank. And then, our final step is, that's where we're gonna grab the scissor and we're gonna actually punch a hole in it. We'll punch a hole, you know, and there you go. That way, that's where you can put your money in the hole, right? You can put a quarter, you can put 25 cents, a dime, a nickel, whatever it is that you want to do, right? I'm going to show you the one I made. Voila, right? This is partially, it looks kind of the same. This is a little bigger because, you know, you get to, I want to save a lot more, right? So then what we do now, once we have our giving bank, you know, we're just going to start saving. Right? And you guys know that if you guys save 25 cents in 30 days, it'll be $7.50 at the end of the month, right? And, you know, imagine how much you can do with that. You can give it away. You can do something for your siblings, something nice. You can use it, you know, for a good purpose. It is not us, right? And that's the whole thing, you know. God reminds us, just be generous, right? Because he's giving us so much already. So just giving back to other people is just another token of appreciation and acknowledging that it is thanks to God that we have all those things. All right, boys and girls, I hope you guys had fun. Please, I'm no Picasso, right? Obviously, you guys can see it's not that nice, but I want you guys to do this at home. Do your piggy bank, you know, or your giving box, and, you know, tag us. You know, make sure, take a picture of it, because we want to see you guys, you know, have a good time just making your box. All right, until next time, bye.
Hey kids, so one way we can remember that everything belongs to God is by looking at the beautiful world that God created. There are a lot of different ways that people play games. I know you guys love to play on your iPads. But I remember growing up that I didn't have an iPad, but I still knew how to play. I still knew how to have fun and play games. And different people from different kids from different nations also can find different ways to play and have fun. So one game we'll be introducing today is called Bujal Bazi from Afghanistan that kids play. And what you do is you just need to make a circle, and that is going to be your ring. And then what we did was find some rocks, so these nice smooth rocks. And so Teacher Vanessa and I have different colored rocks. And so the object of the game is to actually get your opponent's rocks outside of the circle. So we'll have Teacher Vanessa go first. And so what she's gonna do is try to flick her rock so that it gets knocked out of the ring.
Hmm. Yay!
Oh, all right, so one of my rocks went out of the ring, so I lost that one and hers stayed in. So now it's my turn to start and try, and I'm gonna try and knock one out. Oh, I missed. All right, so I lost that one, but you're gonna keep going until one of you has the most rocks left over and someone else loses all their rocks. And here we go. All right, that was great. I'm gonna win, watching. Oh, okay, I messed up.
All right, my turn. Can I touch this?
Yeah, you can touch it.
Okay.
Okay. Oh. Oh, I'm really bad at this game.
Yay!
Okay, I have one rock left. I'm gonna try and save it. Okay, I got one. Oh, okay.
All right.
Oh, I might lose this one. I have one rock left. Oh, okay.
Yay!
So there you have it. If you want to play a quick game, an easy game that doesn't require any technology, and you want to try something new, feel free to use your creativity. Find some rocks, find a partner, or you can just play on your own. And yeah, so have fun, try it out. Let us know how it goes. Bujabazi.
There's just no telling how far I'll go. I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong, I'll be satisfied if I play.